Show me the holy city Jerusalem coming down out of heaven from God. I saw no temple in this city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of the Lord is its light, and its lamp is the Lamb. The nations will walk by its light, and the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. Its gates will never be shut by day, and there will be no night there. Let us pray. Eternal God, you led your ancient people into freedom by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. Grant that we who walk in the light of your presence may rejoice in the liberty of the children of God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And our opening hymn is number 415 if you're using a hymnal, or if you've taken time to print out the order of service, perhaps have it on another device, it's printed right here. When all thy mercies, O my God,
thank you.
we are being afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation. If we are being consoled, it is for your consolation, which you experience when you patiently endure the same sufferings that we are also suffering. Our hope for you is unshaken, for we know that as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our consolation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray responsibly portions of Psalm 145. Begins on page 802 in the prayer book, verses 8 and then 14 through 22, or as provided in your online bulletin. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great kindness.
The Lord is faithful in all his words and merciful in all his deeds.
The Lord upholds all those who fall. He lifts up those who are bowed down.
The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season.
You open wide your hand and satisfy the needs of every living creature.
The Lord is righteous in all his ways and loving in all his works.
The Lord is near to those who call upon him, to all who call upon him faithfully.
He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He hears their cry and helps them.
The Lord preserves all those who love him, but he destroys all the wicked.
My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord. Let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
Amen. Our litany of prayers this evening, it's the prayers of the people during global pandemic, was created and offered first at Washington National Cathedral, with a concluding collect from the Gloucester Cathedral in England. Let us pray. God, our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble, in this challenging and uncertain time of global pandemic and public health crisis, we come before you offering our prayers on behalf of those in need, the Church and the world. For the Church, that it may not grow weary of proclaiming the gospel of Christ, and serve as a beacon of hope to a suffering world. We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Ian and Laura, our bishops, and all who minister in your name. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all affected by the coronavirus around the world, for the leaders of the nations, that they may work together for the common good as the outbreak spreads. May barriers to divide be brought down, that bonds of trust may be strengthened to benefit the entire human family. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant public health and government officials in our nation the strength and will to act swiftly and decisively with wisdom and compassion in service to all. We pray especially for the President of the United States, the Congress, our Governor, and Select. Lord, in your mercy, to reduce its spread. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Watch over all who provide essential services, and all who produce, deliver, and prepare foods, goods, and medicine, that they may be able to serve safely with the protection they need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the safety and well-being of all who travel, and for those who remain quarantined, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Remove the presence of fear and anxiety from our hearts, that confident in your providence, we may be generous in sharing our resources. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that our churches and communities of faith may reflect your love as we seek to minister to the most vulnerable among us. Fill them with your Holy Spirit as they work to be your healing hands and feet to all in need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have already lost loved ones to the virus, and those who will yet suffer such loss, that they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray especially for Joanne Holden. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy. Sustain and support the anxious. Be with those who care for the sick and lift up all who are brought low, that we may find comfort knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Your intercessions, petitions, and thanksgivings are welcome at this time. In our prayers this evening, let us remember Julie, who is now at home and receiving therapy there. For Pam, scheduled for shoulder surgery tomorrow. For Gabrielle and Robin at home. Lisa and Matthew at home. Joan and her daughters. Dale and Michelle at home. Lois, not yet at home. For Annie and Jim, who can't be home together. And for all in financial distress because of the pandemic. We give thanks for the birthday last Friday of Jane Bishop. And let us sum up our prayers as Jesus taught his friends by saying together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us in the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, beseech thee that we may always prove ourselves a people mindful of thy favor and glad to do thy will. Bless our land with honorable industry, sound learning, and pure manners. Save us from violence, discord, and confusion, from pride and arrogance, and from every evil way. Defend our liberties, and fashion into one united people the multitudes brought hither out of many kindreds and tongues. Endue with the spirit of wisdom those to whom in thy name we entrust the authority of government, that there may be justice and peace at home, and that through obedience to thy law, we may show forth thy praise among the nations of the earth. In the time of prosperity, fill our hearts with thankfulness, and in the day of trouble, suffer not our trust in thee to fail. All which we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Blessed are we, O Lord, the God of our fathers, creator of the changes of day and night, giving rest to the weary, renewing the strength of those who are spent, bestowing upon us occasions of song in the evening. As you have protected us in the day that is past, so be with us in the coming night. Keep us from every sin, every evil, and every fear, for you are our light and salvation, and the strength of our life. To you be glory for endless ages. Amen. And our closing hymn is number 469, There's a Wideness in God's Mercy.
Thank you.
us all evermore.